As a physician, I've used many therapies for arthritis in the past without much benefit or with temporary benefit. I've used steroid injections, I've used lidocaine injections, I've used Mobic, I've used Celebrex, I've used naproxyn, Tylenol, all kinds of things. All these therapies basically just put a temporary band-aid, a temporary relief on the pain. Moreover, what we don't talk about a lot is all the dangers that come from taking these medications chronically. Because typically when you've got arthritis, it's not just that you had arthritis for one day or one month, you've got arthritis for life. And the arthritis just keeps getting worse and worse. So as you take these medications, you might need to take more, or you take them for so long that your body begins to deplete of vital nutrients. Take Tylenol, for example. It's been touted as one of the safest medications on the planet, and that's why it's over the counter, and people take it all the time, and Tylenol has been safe, safe, safe. But what you don't know is that Tylenol depletes your glutathione levels. And if you've been watching any of my other blogs or read on my website, glutathione is one of the most precious antioxidants that you make every day. Glutathione helps you anti-inflame the system. It's a detoxifier. It helps get rid of toxins. It helps you lose weight. It helps you improve your brain function. Glutathione is needed to keep your body healthy. So if you're taking Tylenol to eliminate the pain of the knees, yet also creating an environment of inflammation, then your knee pain is going to get worse over time, and then you're going to require more Tylenol, and then your glutathione is going to deplete further. Naproxyn, it raises your risk for stomach ulcers and gastritis and reflux and heartburn, amongst the other dysbiosis and small intestinal bacterial overgrowth and inflammatory bowels that come with chronic non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug use, like naproxyn and Advil and Motrin and Aleve and all those. I'm not saying those are terrible drugs or toxic drugs, because I recommend them frequently, but I don't want you to have to take them for a long time. I'd rather see you get off these drugs. I've seen people take steroids by mouth to help their arthritis, and while this does work, steroids increase your risk for a myriad of things. It raises your blood sugar, and we now know that any level that your blood sugar raises damages proteins in your bloodstream and bowels and in your brain, and these can lead to early signs of Alzheimer's and dementia, and heart attacks and strokes. Sugar damages proteins. The higher the sugar, the more it damages the proteins. So if you're taking these steroids, it's raising the blood sugar, and that's creating damage to these proteins. The other thing is it raises your risk for infection. If you have arthritis, chances are you're a little bit older, and if you're older, you're already at higher risk of pneumonia and ear infections and sinus infections and things that can turn deadly, unfortunately. So why would you take steroids and increase your risk of those infections and increase the potential for those to become deadly infections? The other issue with steroids is it actually thins your muscles. It makes you gain fat. Steroids in high doses makes you put on weight in your cheeks and in the back of your neck and under your throat and in your belly. And it forces muscle tissue to donate their protein to the body. High dose steroids tell the body that it's in a stressful situation and it thinks it's running from a tiger, so it's going to burn all the fuel that it can. The odd part is that it actually puts fat on. And so why would you want to expose yourself to more and more steroids in order to try to limit your knee pain when you've got this alternative option that can regenerate and heal the knee or hip or shoulder or whatever joint is arthritic to begin with? Steroids over time thin your bones. So oral steroids or injected steroids into muscle tissue are certainly the highest dose and worst side effect steroids. But steroids injected into the joint also affect the system. They also increase the blood sugar. They also thin the bones. And we've shown time and time again that if you continuously inject steroids into a joint, you actually extend the speed of the damage in the joint, and the joint gets worse over time. The joint is more damaged, and the cartilage lasts even, or the cartilage gets damaged quicker. And so it speeds up the arthritis, and that's the last thing you want. A lot of people are using steroid injections for their joints, and so I want to talk a little bit about those, because I've done many steroid injections over my career as a physician, and I want to say that they definitely help. If you're suffering from joint pain, a steroid injection can definitely help the pain. The problem is they've done studies to show that if you recurrently get joint injections, and the most you can do is one every 3 or 4 months, but if you continue to get joint injections every 3 or 4 months, it actually shows that it increases the damage in your joint. joint. It speeds up the damage in the joint. And this just makes sense. Your body's inflaming the joint. It's calling for help. It's telling you to stop stepping on me. It hurts. Stop doing this. And it's calling for help. Inflammation is your body calling for help, saying, come heal me. And so instead of saying, come heal me, now you're sticking a steroid in there and you're telling the body, stop. Stop healing itself. Stop inflaming. Just stop doing everything. And so what happens, of course, the damage just keeps going and going. Now, there's a difference between chronic inflammation and acute inflammation. So chronic inflammation is damaging to the joint. And so if you get into a chronic situation where it's just chronically inflamed, then it does hurt and it will damage it. That's still not to say that a steroid injection is going to benefit you. A steroid injection will deteriorate the cartilage, the ligaments, the soft tissue even faster. That's why we don't use cortisol or steroids in scar tissue, because if you inject cortisol or steroids into a scar tissue, it delays the healing. It prevents it from healing very well, and then you can't fight infection very well, and so you're more likely to get an infection in the area. So steroids in general offer a temporary band-aid to a problem, but they're not a solution. They're one of the only solutions people have until they get a joint replacement, but that's because so many people don't even know about stem cell therapy. So PRP, stem cell therapy, is definitely the way to go for arthritis. For most people that get treatment, it's usually just a one-time treatment, and then they're great for years. Everyone's a little different, so you're not sure if you're going to need a repeat injection, and it also depends on how bad the damage was. We'll be right back.